we have additional column for log. So if our calculation is for a kind of advanced to that level, so such additional column is going to be used. But let us continue with this. So my table has to be ruled in this form. So I remember I'm going to make use of two numbers at a go. So I have here 15.47 and 0.08525 squared. Now then, the first thing one has to do here is to determine the characteristic. But before we go into talking about characteristics, there is this attention I want to call the student to once again, and the attention is in any situation whereby either of the numbers or both numbers given carries a power or a root, then it shows that the one that does not carry a power is not going to be recorded there, so will rather be recorded there. While this one that carries a power still needs some processes, so that's what we are going to record there. So when the process has been carried out, the overall effect it has will be transferred there, where it's going to mix with the other number that is together with it here. So which means, for me, you can see that this one occurred singly. It is without power and it's without any root. Why this one is with the power of 2? So it shows that this one will have to undergo the second column first. So when I process it, that is, when these 2 have taken its normal root, then that is going to be transferred there. But like this one that occurs singly like this, that doesn't have any such character, it will not be recorded here at all. So it will be recorded here straight. So let's go. So I have 15.47. So the first thing here is to determine the characteristic. So we can see the first number here is a whole number. Sorry, the first number here is a natural number, what we can call a counting number. So it shows this is going to is a number greater than 1. So since it's a number greater than 1, then the next thing that will come to the first thing we need to know is this first 1 here. Since this is a number, it's a positive, it's a number greater than 1, it shows that the first number I have here is now what? My first digit, why this 5 is the second digit. Then the next thing is I want the decimal point between 1 and 5. That is, between the first digit and the second digit, decimal point has to be there. So since the decimal point is not there, we'll go and locate where we have the decimal point and move it from wherever it is up to this place where we want it to be. So this is the original position of decimal point that was given according to this number. But we don't want it here, we want it between this 1 and 5. So how many times do I have to move the decimal point into this place? So that can only be done once. It can only be done once. So it shows that the characteristic there is going to be 1. And likewise, this one. Now we can see the first number written here is 0. And remember, any time that we observe 0 is the first number, so then such a number is a case of number less than 1. So which means in all the places where we see 0, so 0 is not going to be treated as the first digit. So the first is going to be the first natural number, that is the first counting number we have in this case. So this one is 0, this one is 0, so this one is not qualified to be my first digit. Likewise, this one as well is not qualified to be my first digit. So my first digit in this case is what? 8. While the second digit is what? 5. So a mere fact that this thing is a case of number less than 1 shows is going to have a characteristic, a negative characteristic, that is a characteristic that's going to carry what? A bar. Now, how many of such 0 do we have here? We have 2 of it, so that's one of the way we can know the characteristics. Other way we can do it is decimal point wanting to be between the first digit and second digit. So how many times do we move it from here up to this place? So it can be done like this, 1, 2. So that's going to be bar 2. And another idea to think that is, we may not bother ourselves with the movement of the point. So what we just do is, once it begins with 0, how many 0 does this thing start with? It started with 2 0. So that's going to be bar 2. That's another approach towards we can obtain what? The characteristics. Then the next is to obtain the value of log 15 under 4 with the difference of 7. And by the table here, so I have log 15 here is 1761, Lord, 15. That's a mistake. I have 15 under 4 is what I need here. 1875 with the difference of 7. Difference of 7 here is 20. So when I did 5981. Say here I have 1895. And as for this one, the only number we have here is 85. So it shows that we're going to look up for what? 85 under 0. So and by the table here, 85 under 0 gives the value of 9294. So this is 9294. And remember, this second number here has a power. And remember, the what of power, if the power is a whole number, I'm not talking of the case of a fractional power. If the power happens to be a whole number, then such a number, such a number means we should multiply this thing by whatever power it has or it carries. But here, whereby the power is a fraction, that is one that calls for division. So let us note that once again. If the power is a whole number, so we are going to multiply in that case. And if the case is the one that the power is a fractional number, it's just that we are going to divide. So now we know we want to multiply here. So it's going to multiply by what? 2. So when I multiply this thing by 2, 2 times 4, 8. 2 times 9 is 18. With the remainder of what? 1. 2 times 2, 4. Plus that 1, I have 5. 2 times 9 here is 18. With the remainder of 1. Then 2 times minus 2 here gives minus 4. Then plus that 1. So minus 4 plus 1 I have here, that gives minus 3, which is the same thing as what? Bar 3. So here I have it as bar 3. So we can see that this number has now been fully processed. It is after it has been fully processed now that we can now relate the value it has with the first number here. So I am now free to write bar 3.8588. And we can see that between this first number and the second number, there's a multiplication sign. And by the rules of logarithm, multiplication changes to what? To addition. So adding that means 8 plus 4. 5 plus 8 here is 13. So 3 will be written with the remainder of 1. 1 plus 9, 10 plus 8, that is 18. I still have the remainder of 1. 1 plus 8, 9 plus 5, that is 14. 4 will be written here with the remainder of 1. 1 plus 1 plus 8 here gives what? 10. So 0 will be written. Point. So I also have to move my 1 here. Now what we do here is to say that 1 plus 1 plus minus 3. So I have 1 plus 1 plus minus 3. So which means 1 plus 1 here is 2. Plus times minus minus 3. And we know 2 minus 3 is minus 1, which is the same thing as bar 1. So this base is going to be bar 1. So now we are done with the numerator, so we can now shift our attention to that of the denominator. So in the denominator, only one number is given, and that is 254 raised to power 1/3. So the first thing we're going to do is to obtain the characteristic. Now, then the number here, the number determines the nature of the characteristics, be it a positive characteristic or a negative characteristic. But once we observe this in very well, we can see that the first number written here is a whole number. So, is a natural number, what we can call a counting number. So, since it is that, then it shows this is the case of number greater than 1. Now, once it is that, then the next thing we want to do is, we definitely we know the first digit is 2, while the second digit is what? 5. Then the next thing is one decimal point, it's compulsory for a decimal point to be between this first digit and second digit. And for it to be here, we have to locate where is the decimal point. Now, when we observe this number, it looks as if the decimal point is not there. So, in the next video, whereby the number is written like this, that we can't see directly the decimal point, then we are going to assume so that what decimal point is at the back of the last digit. That is, the decimal point comes last. So, and what we want to do with this decimal point is that it is important we move it between 2 and 5. And how many times is that possible? So, it can be done like this, 1, 2. So, that is done 2 times. So that's going to be 2 points. Then the rest is to look up for the value of 25.4. In a normal situation, I will have written this thing here. But because this thing still carries a power, it still needs some processes. So that's the reason why it has such a process has to be carried out here. And whatever result we obtain will be transferred here for completion of whatever we have to do. Here we are going to look up for 25 under 4. So I'm by my table. 25 under 4 gives the value of 4048. I have 4048. And we can see we have a fractional power. Fractional power will change to what? To division. So that means we should divide by 3. And we can see that this division is very possible in this situation because this number here, this first number is not a negative number. So once it's a positive number, division is very possible. So what we shall do there is to say that how many 3 can we get into? We know that it's not possible. That is going to be 0. So the 2 will rather be transferred there, making 24. 3 in 24 here is 8. And 3 in 0 here gives 0. 3 in 4 here gives 1, with the remainder of 1. So 3 in 18 here is 6. So the value I have here is 0.8016. And between the numerator and the denominator is the division. And you know by logarithm, division changes to what? To subtraction. So we are going to subtract there. So 3 minus 6, not possible. I borrow 1 from here, making 13. 13 minus 6 here is 7. Now this is now 7. 7 minus 1 here gives what? 6. 4 minus 0 here is 4. 0 minus 8 here is not possible. So I'll rather run to this place to borrow 1. So when 1 gets here, it becomes 10. 10 minus 8 here is what? 2. I remember once I borrow 1 from this. This number will change, will become what? Minus 2. So it's like we are incurring debt to a debt. So that debt will be more. So it's going to be minus 2. So here I now have minus 2 minus 0. We know that's going to give minus 2. And in the logarithm slogan, minus is what we call bar. So it now becomes bar 2. So to round up with what we are doing here is to now determine the antilog of what we have here. So I can now say that antilog of bar 2.2467. So I would prefer writing that. Okay, I can put it there. So what we check is antilogarithm of 0.24 under 6 with difference of 7. And by the table of antilog here, I want 0.24 under 6. That gives 1762 difference 7. Difference of 7 here is 3. So when added, I have 5, 6, 7. So 1765. That is 1765. Now, the last thing we're going to do now is, as at the time we're looking up for the value of antilog, this first number, that is the characteristics in this case, was not recognized. So for me to report the final answer, I have to take cognizance of the number which I have here. So I can see the number here is bar 2. What does bar 2 mean, or what it will go, the way we are going to interpret it is to say that what this number we have here has to begin with 0. So you can see the bar here or negative sign here has its row, and 2 here also has its row. What the bar here is saying is what I have here must begin with some 0. That is, it doesn't start with what? With a natural number. Because I'm looking for a place where the decimal point is going to be put. And for decimal point to be inserted here, this thing is saying, this bar here is saying that this number must has to start with some numbers that are not natural number. That are not a natural number, that is, that are not counting numbers. So that is, some numbers there has to be 0. So it has to begin with 0. But how many of such 0 is it going to be? So it is the number we have under bar that it is that. So we can see this is 2. So it shows 2 of such numbers will come before we see 1 at 7, 6, 5. So the result here is now going to be 0.0. So final answer to evaluating 15.47 multiplied by 0.085 squared divided by 254 raised to the power 1 over 3 gives the value of what?